Hello friends of the Northern Entertainment and welcome back to another mod review here on my channel. We have today the Guldner G75A, a tractor from the 60s, a nice little tractor that will make a good companion on a small farm or on a bigger farm just for some, well, haul jobs and whatnot if you want to have an older tractor on your farm. I usually have at least one old tractor on my farm, even if I play on a modern farm, just because, well, you know how farmers are, they never throw anything away, so you will find the oldest tractor besides the newest machine, and this old little tractor will have some kind of a job. That all being said, this is a mod that shows you that a well-modeled 3D model, it doesn't have to be big and heavy. This mod comes in at a modest 21 megabytes, and it's made by Deep Blue. You can download it from modhoster.com. Or modhoster.de, depending on whether you want to have the HTTPS warning or not. But now you can see here, it comes in as a small tractor, of course, at $18,950. And it comes in a whole bunch of different versions. Let's do a quick pan around here and have a look. You can really see and appreciate the detail. And as I said, the mod itself is not a hefty mod. It has a lot of detail, but it is well modeled, and by that, it has only 21 megabytes. 600 kgs front weight is one of the configuration standards. And you can also put a front loader attacher on it if you have the front loader attacher. There's actually two different ones. There is modern style, and there's an olden style one. The wheel setup, we have wheel weights, we have wide tires, we have wide tires and weights, we have rear narrow twin wheels, and we have normal full-size twin wheels, and we have narrow tires all around. That's what we have on the wheel side of things. And then what we also have here is the G75A in the year 1965, which was 70 horsepower or 51 kilowatts, and then the 67 version, which had 55 kilowatts or 75 horsepower. Both have 100 liter fuel tanks and both max out at 32 kilometers per hour. That being said, we have a couple of different options here. One is with a simple rollover protection. One is with a normal roof. Then we have a roof with provisions for the rear, for a rear tarp. Now, I do not think, or at least I haven't figured out how, if you know how and I just missed that, then that's my bad, but I don't think there is an actual tarp in the back. It's just the provisions for it. And then you have the one without the rear tarp, as well as the front doors are missing. And again, you have that for both. You have that for the the different engine versions here, as you can see. That being said, let's get out again and have a look at the sounds and lights. So here we have the tractor with the provisions for the rear tarp, as you can see. As I said, I don't think you can actually close that tarp. I at least haven't figured out how. However, you can raise and lower the sides and can have this as a rather open experience if you choose to do so. Or, of course, if the rain comes, then you want to make sure that this is closed. You can also, when you hit X, oh, I was wrong, there you go. So the rear tarp is actually coming down. There you go, I was wrong. I admit that freely. But yeah, you see here that you have this then completely closed. Rain can come from each direction except from below, but if you have water coming in from below, you have other problems than just that. That being said, let's have a look here, or let's have a listen to the engine. Oh, old diesel. Old diesel, how I love though. And you can see, yeah, the standard stuff, the standard good stuff with turning drive shaft. which, if you think about of the year of this tractor, means that this is an all-wheel drive, and that is not a given for that year. That was actually something that was rather new, especially for the general public, so to speak. But yeah, it's definitely, it is a very nicely modeled out tractor. A lot of detail, a lot of detail. That said, let's open this all up and have a look at the lights. So we got, of course, our turn signals, front as well as back. We have brake signal. Oh, brake light, brake signal, whatever that is. We do have rear work lights, and we don't have any special lights. Oh yeah, we do have special lights in the front. We have work lights in the front, I'm sorry. And we have headlights, as well as high beams. On the inside, you can hear the turn signals are going. And if I move the wheel a little bit, then you can see that we have also indicators for the turn signal, as well as indicators for the normal light. Don't think there's an indicator for high beams. No, there is not. However, there is an indicator for the work lights, and that is nice too. So everything that you would expect to find on a tractor like this, you will actually have. Now, what good does it do if you have a tractor with a front loader attachment and no front loader arm to attach to it? And for that, this mod comes with a very nicely modeled out Bass front loader arm, and with a assortment of attachments. Of course, here being a normal shovel, a small manure fork, a bale spike, a shovel for the potatoes and beets, and or for all the earthen fruits, and then of course a large manure fork. And they are, as I said as well, they are very nicely modeled out. There is a lot of detail that you can see here on all of them, as much detail as you would expect, really, or as much detail as you can expect from a attachment from the time period. We're gonna have a quick look. And here we have the arm that costs you, or the front loader that costs you 2700, the normal shovel 1400 with 750 liters volume. Then you have the small manure fork at 1500, 980 liter volume. The spale spike at 1500, and then you have, as I said here, you have the bigger shovel that is technically, it's only for the earthen fruits, but of course you can use it for pretty much anything if you choose to do so. And then at 1400, and this one has a volume of 2250, and the manure fork, the big one with 2980 liters of a volume. So yeah, that's it really for this mod. Again, the link is in the description below. I do hope you enjoyed this little mod preview. And yeah, I am back. I'm back to stay. I again apologize for the long time between it, but I had some health issues to deal with. And yeah, long story short, I'm back. I'm back with more. And I hope you liked it. If you did, hit the like button, leave a comment below, share it with your friends. And I will talk to you guys very soon. This is the Northern Alex signing off. Thanks for watching, and God bless.